Hi guys, welcome to episode 44 of the Soviet Republic Sputnik Challenge, Workers and Research Soviet Republic Sputnik Challenge. Quite a word if you stutter. My name is Kai Maya and today we're going to talk, because things got a little bit heated, about the pollution, and we're going to do something about that. And I'm starting on post because Adam had a suggestion. And I just thought that this was a great way to point it out that the buses are being held up by all the pedestrians here. So we need to figure out a way how to handle that. So let's see this in action. You see that they're slowing down because of it. Okay, you're not. You're a bad driver. Okay, so let's get started on how we can. Can we fix this? And we can probably do this as easy as creating a road like here. And I also wanted to upgrade or some of the road anyway. So what we're going to do, I'm going to redo you because you're not really straight. Oh, I had this the first time as well. That this road didn't go straight. Like so. So upgrade those. So yeah, for improvement we need to have some more pedestrians going here to begin with. So assign like you and you and you and you. You can have a lower priority. Okay, that's one. And then we also, I would like to do that here actually. Upgrade these ones. Like you? No. I thought you were two pieces. Go. And let me see. You are already can exit there. You can exit here. You can exit here. You're upgraded. You need a temporary. Oh no, I can just put you like so, probably, and build that. And then this is covered as well. Okay. I am wanting to move to a point where I let the construction officers decide for themselves what to upgrade. So, that's one. Then we are waiting for these to be finished and then we can have a cleaner water source. So we're using less chemicals. Another thing is the pollution thing. I have to get something off my chest. Please don't shout in the comments section. And thank you. But you do make a good point, all of you, about the pollution. If I look at it, population statistics, all. If I look at the death, you know, it's pretty steady until here, and here it starts to explode, kind of thing. And I think it has to do with the fact that you started using our power plant then, and I think that the seasonal changes are due to the heating plant, yes, but together with the power plant, I think it's too much. The 400 meters we talked, you mentioned, it's even further than that. If I take the first, this is 443, 500. Frankie also said because of the buildings are so close together, I think it all has to do with each other. So yeah, what I want to do, because we are going to create a city there, right? And so is it really easy to have a heating plant all the way there, or maybe somewhere in the middle, somewhere here or something, so it can provide both cities, plus generate less pollution. And the power plant, whole sentence. Does it really make sense to have a gas power plant fueled by oil all the way up here? Well, here we are getting all the oil. And while we're at this area, I completely forgot this well is done. Oh, where are you? You are done. But no distribution of assigned. So, let's do that. Here. And add new, like you, here. And load, better to load here, the oil. Also, I think now we're going further and further away. We don't have enough buses. I'm going to buy, I think, oil tank. Two more. Okay, so that's that. And then I'm also in this episode, hopefully not forgetting to improve, to start building these ones and to upgrade these roads and stuff. So then for the, I thought about creating a gas power plant here, and then I can connect to the power grid there. And for that, if I press F2, I can't put it here just like this. So I was thinking of creating a temporary, let's press the right button, temporary construction office here, like something like so. Oh, and add you, say that you don't look for stuff here, but I do, well, sorry, I do want to have you go on this flatbed. And let's push pause, because there's a flatbed missing here. Oh, because you are going. No, you are not from. Okay, let me first assign this one here. Go. Okay. And then, where is my flatbed for you? What are you doing? Where are you? Okay. Go on, hurry up. That totally makes sense, because I just ordered you to do that, so yeah. And so, you go to your home, please. Okay. Then please go onto that flatbed and you go work there. Okay. Then I want to switch back to the comment. This we started out with a comment of Adam, who said, random and off-topic thought, the road access to the bus station is getting blocked with pedestrians, and it's slowing every bus down. It's not a huge deal, but is there a better way? Well, we are working on it, and let me see. Kuba said, what I meant was to further upgrade the main road between the roundabout and the bypass. This is this part of the road. Yes, we need to upgrade that. And he continued that he said and pointed out that bypass south of the cinema going west to road connecting transformer where you connected substations and by which is one end prison and on the other the secret police. Yes, that is a great idea. Because I can't get past this here, so let's just deal with the fact that it's not going as quick as we would like with the transport. I'm not going to be able to do this, right? But this game has its ways. Oh no, I am messing up here. So please go. No, really not? No? No. Okay, then maybe spread you out a little bit. Okay, try again. This is going to be really? Oh, that's okay. Okay, like so. And then, let's press play, because our many of my numbers. No, 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 no. We can do this. So, upgrade. You. Remove you. Yeah. And remove you. So, upgrade. Hi. Priority. Okie dok. Okay. Am I correct here? No. No. Like so. Okay. Then I want to buy some vehicles here. Because we are going to dig the canal. Yes, we are going to dig the canal. Not as wide, but almost, because I will come back to that later. And it's not going to look ridiculous. It's going to look really beautiful. Is the hope. But I'll come back to that. Buy a vehicle or mechanisms. We have money now. So I'm going to buy 5 excavators. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, why? We have 3 here. 3. One is on route now. Let's press this. Plus the 5 here makes that we are moving towards our Sputnik goal, because we now have bought all mechanism for the monument. So there's that. What we can do to reduce pollution right away is stop this gas power plant, but I think it's also safe to wait until it gets colder. So what we must forget to do now is to take a look at our loyalty is 47%, and I think if I look at this loyalty, we might up it 5%. Yes. Okay. What else do I want to do now? I think we can safely go to the build the power plant thing here. No, because you're not arrived. Where are you? Oh, you're taking your time. Where's the... Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, we can also speed you up a bit. Or we can play and look at the comments a bit. Let's do that. I'm really excited on moving this, actually. Yeah, comments from old to new. And this comment is from Ethan. And it's a pretty long comment, but it gives a lot of insight about loyalty. And he says, just to clarify, having more cinemas won't automatically raise the culture preferences of citizens. You need to either actively influence preference with radio TV, design your republic so that citizens only replace needs you don't like or cannot provide, or actively ignore needs you don't support, not recommended for loyalty, worker efficiency, and station capacity. Attractions can be used to replace the needs of prey, sports, culture, and drinking, and lower the preference for them, but without the citizens getting upset. Other needs like food, meat, clothes, doctor visits, etc. cannot be replaced. There are 3 kinds of attractions. Buildings with star scores in the menu. But for replacing the needs of citizens, the only kind that matters is the one that displays attraction type in its info card, such as carousels or museums. Let me take a look. I have only 1 monitor, so I cannot do attraction type carousels. It's actually... I thought you misspelled it, but the attraction type is actually carousels, and they got an O there. Yeah. Oh yeah, so these are carousels, restaurants, beach cafe, gallery of art, galleries. I've never looked at the attraction type. You see, the beach and the restaurant don't have an attraction type, only a score. That's interesting. A theater that doesn't have an attraction type. Pools and beaches. So, I never knew this. Side towers. So you have zoos, side towers, pools and beaches, and the theater was an attraction type, museums, and carousels. Interesting, very interesting. Let me see. The Republic Theater cannot replace Nice because it doesn't have an attraction type. Citizens can still satisfy culture there though. Although citizens do not care about the scores of attractions in any way, only tourists care about scores. So this is the benefit of having attractions in your Republic while you're not having hotels or importing tourists. After replacing a need, citizens cannot replace a new need at the same type of attraction, museums, carousel, side tower, etc. for a set period of time that is defined in the INI file of the building. This is why it is important to have multiple types so that citizens can always replace a need you don't like. These times will vary between 4 and 20 days, 60 in real life seconds at normal speed. Side towers have the longest cool downs and beaches and indoor pools have the shortest. Am I playing or playing on? Yeah, yeah. I just wanted to make sure that I was not playing on fast forward here. Because I think you have arrived and I have to kind of press you and you. And I want to delete you for now. So you don't go getting fuel here. And so I want to ask you to go back to your place because now these are not functioning. You go there. Ah, that's other. how do you say this? Other way of doing this. Do this first, and then remove the road. Okay. Well, what was I thinking? You go there. And you go there. Okay, then let's wait until you have gone and then remove the road. Okay. So then where was I? The last sentence I said was, these times will vary between 4 and 20 days, 60 in real life seconds at normal speed. Side towers have the longest cooldown and beaches and indoor pools have the shortest. Some attractions can also pull double duty and satisfy sport or culture in addition to replacing needs, even if the citizen has not finished their cooldown period after replacing a need at that type of building. A citizen who replaces the need to pray at the beach can still visit the next day to satisfy their sports need. The only exception to this is the art gallery, which will forbid citizens who replace a need there from satisfying culture there until their cool down period is finished. Ideally, you would have a passenger line that picks off everyone at the station, drives to another one where they can satisfy the leisure need you're fine with, and a final station after that where the remaining citizens can replace needs you don't want with attractions. Well, Ethan, this was a very interesting comment and a very interesting reply. I knew none of this, to be honest. I thought attractions were only for tourists. Town. So I'm definitely going to want to put this in action, but not in this episode. I want to build the gas station now because, well, you know, we need to. Let's pause you. I want to see you are this full, and I'm probably going to use this one as well. You are this full. I want to see if it's still true that if you terraform in post mode that that you're not select you first that you're not using fuel. Sometimes you have to kind of look how the system works and if it still works as you thought. Okay, and then I'm going to get you. I'm going to do some terraforming using this one because it goes way quicker. Or not. Why do you do this? Okay. I just want to have some, so that if I place the, let me see if I can place you now, or if you are still going to, no, you're not going to do what I want you to do. I need some more room for that. Okay, let's see how we're doing like this, if you want to put this at this level. Go like this. Okay, gas power plant. Now you don't want to do anything anymore now, why not? Oh, I hate this. Anyway, I'm just going to do it like this. Okay. This is taking a long time. So, and I can't read the comments now, but because that's what would be ideal, because I only have one monitor, as I said. Okay. Let's see how you like this one. Still not? Why? I am still wanting to do it like this, actually. This is going better, I think. Okay. Okay. I want to flatten you here. Okay. Now, please do what I want you to do. Okay, thank you. I want you to turn you around like so. Okay. And I want to have some room next to it. For this, because I need to switch as well. And the road also has some room here. Why it takes so long? You only have one excavator. Why won't you I will tell from. Go away. More. Okay. How about this? Think about this. That one. Okay. So one like this, probably. I need more room here. To the right. Okay. How about like this? I don't think this is straight. I think this is straighter. Is it? None of this is actually straight. Okay, put you in. Excellent. Then put in the road. The road. Thank you. That little bit, like so. I think this is straight here, but not here. So this road is probably not straight. Something like that. Okay, and then we need to put a switch. 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 So, if I put you, do I put you further to the back right? Because otherwise I will block the medium voltage output. And I think, how about something like this? I hope I can connect you. How many megawatts are we? 1050. So we can do 14, 10, 8, 10, this one. Put you in. Put the road in. Okay, I think we're done here. Do I have... No, I think I'm going to do it like this. Okay, that was this part. Well, we can assign the construction offices to start working on this. Here. And press play. Before that, I want to reassign you to your original construction offices again. And then this was our little it's empty, so pausing and doing this does still have its what are you, the excavator Steinbeck. I didn't use you a lot, so play. Okay, then we need buses. And I thought of creating a little bus station here for the workers to work there and there. So, bus station. Road cargo, bus. And I have a tiny bus station. Are you? This one. I like this one. So, one. Going like so. And start out with doing it in mud road. Okay. Assign all construction offices. Did I assign all? Maybe not. Just we need just to hurry up. And then what I want to do is that our gas power station is at after the first phase of the concrete and the gravel, and then I'm going to start assigning. Oh no, you already have the first phase here, right? Yeah. But I don't want to do constructions happening at the same time. So, and we also need to cut this wire down and go from there and go to there. But if I do that now, none of our pump jacks will work. And now I want to do this once this is finished. Oh, I'm forgetting one minor detail. We need a pipe connection. And I don't know. Like so. Do we need a pump station here? I don't... think so. I hope not. Okay, that's that. And then bought a couple of excavators, and which are nowhere to be found. So where are you? Oh, there, here, here, halfway, halfway there. Okay. So we are harvesting now. So I'm not sure. Are we harvesting now? Yeah. I did forget to buy more vehicles. Do we buy more vehicles, or are we going to see if we can manage with the vehicles we are having? I'm going to see if we can manage this with the vehicle we are having now. Okay, loyalty. How far are we? 49. And because we've played in pause mode for... I do see this above 60%. How about... you? No, spouse. You? And then go 5% extra and see if we get enough workers. And how is our rating now? 60% it was. That's nice. That's very nice. How long are we in? 32 minutes. Half an hour episode. So I want to quickly go over some of the comments. Let's see if we keep having enough workers here. Because yeah. 30 minutes is really short. If you get what I mean. Especially if I'm explaining things and stuff. So Tilomus said the Pure Land excursion was nice. Pictures works so much better than words. The micromanagement of the loyalty setting speeds up the loyalty increase quite a bit. Great you show that. Thank you. The for now gone article tells about people influencing others with their loyalty, especially teachers. It says teachers with high loyalty make a big difference. Well, let's put that to the test, or not to the test. Let's increase you to 50. Because you are 50, you are 60 now, to 55, yeah. Let's see how that goes. Okay, we have enough actors, even at 60%, I see. On the pollution, for the years your republic exists, it was always the winters when the death waves occurred. New industry way east of the power plant should affect the town's pollution noticeably. Also, the power plant in the summer seems to harm only little. But I guess being so close to the heating plant, both running on full capacity, will become toxic for the town. Yeah, that is, I think that is what's happening. It's the combination of the two. Tipping an acceptable lifespan for some months, 10 to 15 years lower. Causing a lot at that age to die, probably. Yeah, we are going to see how this is going to work out once we've also... replace the heating plant and see how our little town thrives with that. Ryan Fireball says Stephen Silverbird have reviewed the community report here, so you can indirectly read them there. Yes, those are a very good series he makes. Every time a community report comes out, he will review those, and I can really recommend those. Shaky the Shark had something interesting. Said, if you need fewer to go to the uni in-house, set the students to go to a specific school, not own choice. And when they finish school, they will not go to uni. I never knew this. And I looked at it. And for instance, if we want to have one of them was one of these are called smart people, uni people. So I can say another one. And I can say, well, the babies, you can't do anything there. Children, you can say, go to this school. And then they won't go to university, apparently. So, I can't really put this to the test, because if I would do this, yeah, we can see... children with university education. If we look at a couple of months later, those people are not going to the university, because I've been doing some calculations and we only need 600 to 700 uni educated people. If I add up what's in the hospital and in the university and in the here and in those processing plants. And we are currently, we're having 2,200, so we only need a third of that. And I want to look how we can reduce this. This is all also doing, this is also doing something, I think. We might increase it a bit. But you, on forehand, you never know how this is going to affect you. Hi, you're coming, it's busy. So, oh yeah, because you are pretty slow. And I'm wanting to get rid of all those microbuses. They're clogging up everything. So, this is clean here. So, it seems to work. Excellent. Okay, then very quickly, I have four more comments. Frankie says, so as I've seen, all buildings make pollution as well as apartment buildings. And I think your apartment buildings are very dense, so they probably have an additional small impact. The display by the pollution station seems very rough to me. It's already showing green, although there are still some pollution as far as my observations are concerned. Thanks and cheers. Thank you, Frankie. And I remember the road to the... You're not done. You're not done. Maybe I would want to have my construction offices search for themselves now. Oh no, that can't. No, I can't do that now. So, is anyone coming to build this road? Or are we just... yeah, we are on the other way of the map. Kaimaya. We're stuck because... What are you doing? What? Oh yeah, you have to take the detour. Ooh, okay. Maybe not the smartest decision to do it in this... this way. Second time this episode. Okay. Sorry, guys. 68 people says, Hi, Kaimaya. Pollution, the reason your health goes up and down is to do with seasonal change. In the summer, we don't need anything. So in the winter, the heating plant goes into overdrive and your pollution will skyrocket. Oh, this I already said. I'm sorry. Adam says, pollution, 400 meters. It's always been 400 meters. It's still 400 meters. Pollution from any pollution-producing building can't go any more than 400 meters. With a lot of exclamation mark. Why is there a discussion on this? It's proven over and over, hard-coded into the game. Yeah, maybe I needed this wake-up call, but I would appreciate not shouting. I've 2,500 hours into the game. And yeah, this many hours, then you tend to have or start having your ways of doing it. And maybe it's a bit harder than to be really convinced that it's other than you always... That it's different than you've always thought, or I always thought. So we're now going to move you. I think in the, when it gets winter, I'm going to turn you off, like in October or maybe end of September. And then we're going to import power if this power plant isn't done by then. But with the speed this is going, it's going to take a while. Okay. Yeah, we are 40 minutes in. I'm sorry, guys. But, man. And Adams also said, why is this more lifespan? Because that had third world immigrants imported not long ago, whereas the other one is full of healthy babies. Yeah, that's the immigrants, their lifespan is different. That's true. Chuck says, I think you are misinterpreted the information on the electrical substation window. It seems that you are looking only at the total wattage of all connected buildings. Let's go there for a second. Oops, here. That this was the last episode when I connected. Where are you? You. And I will open you and this substation here. So here we can see the that this substation is the most heavy used with the number of connection. Above it says for the building and below for that specific building, and below is considered all buildings, and you also have a higher priority now. So I think if we, for instance, have this substation as a higher priority. I'm not sure how that works, but this one will be, most of the buildings want to use this one or something. I don't know. I don't know what higher priority means. Anyway, that was not what his comment was about. It seems that you are looking only at the total wattage of all connected buildings and failing to consider that many of the buildings are connected to other substations. I don't believe that adding additional substations will reduce the total wattage of all connected buildings. I think the wattage needs gauge and the digital readout below. It provides information that's more useful once additional substations enter the picture. And Kuba replied, their upper value is not influenced by other substations connected to the same building, but lower estimated maximum consumption is the one that is influenced and should be kept below 100%. It may be not as important if you have buildings that work and thus demand power from time to time, but for areas with constant demands like flats, meat storages or services, it is critical to consider. Yes. And once we connected this one, the below was, this was 121 if I remember correctly, and then it wasn't working anymore. So I want to thank you all for your lovely and nice comments, and I'm really anxious to know what the effect this is going to have the coming winter. And if I do like the heating station, I was thinking of, you know, putting it somewhere there. As I said earlier in the episode, I remember. Okay. I hope you have a nice day. And thank you for taking your time to look at the Sputnik Challenge. I wish you a very nice day and see you next time. Bye-bye.